So what's up YouTube, welcome to the channel Company Tech Review and welcome to another walk around of the Pulsar 150, and this one is in the BS6 2021 model. So this one is the bike which started it all, mainly because of the reliable engine and also the styling which is reminiscent of the old Pulsars, mainly the fuel tank which is a 13 plus liter fuel tank, and the DTSI engine which is a twin spark engine, and it has 5-speed gearing. It has been refined over the years and it is one of the most smoothest, and also the gears are really slick while you engage it. It has two horns, which is also good for, and it is the only bike I believe in the 150cc class vehicles. It comes with fuel injection, and for first time it has single channel ABS, unlike the earlier Pulsar which has the combi braking system. So single channel ABS is a good touch. The rear also gets a disc which has RLP, which is rear wheel lift off protection. It has certain sensors which ensures that once when you do the front braking, the rear wheel doesn't lift. The suspension duties are carried forward by the rear being an adjustable Nitroc suspension and the front being a telescopic unit. If driven carefully, then you can expect a mileage of around 45 to 50, which is also really good. The quality of the parts like the side stand kick rod and also the brake is of good quality. You also get this heat plate which is on the side, and it is in chrome, and also there's one more heat plate over here. At the bottom you get the engine cowl which looks nice, and this hides the BS6 canister. The cradle, the frame is a double cradle frame, and this only improves the overall stability and makes the bike more long lasting, mainly because it has a very nice and a rigid frame. In the front, the Pulsar's reminiscent dome, and this one is the halogen unit. It gets pilot headlights. As I said, the turn indicators are the halogen ones, which gets the flex type treatment, which is also really nice. On the side you have the gear rod, and the gearing is one down and all up. This is 5-speed gearing, the DTSI engine which is twin spark, and the gearing is also really smooth. It also has the side stand indicator which is also really good. For the 150cc segment, this is the only bike which comes with a full chain cover, and this is a metal unit, again catering to the executive segment of the buyers. It also has a nice rear sari guard. This one is the rear drum unit, and it also has the internal tire hugger, and the rear portion of the vehicle gets this number plate light, and also the rear tail light is an LED unit. There's a nice grab handle, and for the NS twin disc, I believe this is a split unit. The seat is a nice long and a comfortable seat, and the cushioning also is really nice. The graphics of the vehicle look striking, and it also has the tank extension which only adds to the overall muscularity of the vehicle. So all in all, it is a nice package for close to 1,20,000. On road you get a very nice vehicle with all the features that you can ever ask for. The main addition or the improvement is to the instrumentation console, and this one is a part analog and a digital unit. As you can see, the digital portion gets a completely overhaul, where it gets the side stand indicator, low battery indicator, the fuel gauge is in this mode, and also there is IFE and AFE, which is average fuel in economy, and also there is distance to empty. So this is the change which has been incorporated, and also if you can see, there is the ABS logo. On the switchgear quality, Bajaj has given it all. Like, these are backlit and it comes with high beam flasher. The switchgear quality also looks pretty nice, and as you can see, the horn is also pretty loud, which is a twin horn. The mirrors also is pretty wide and gives a good visibility of the passengers who are coming behind. So overall, it's a good bike for the money that you pay. So I hope you enjoyed this walk around shoot. If you do so, please like and subscribe to my channel. This is Kevin signing off, and see you in the next one. Bye bye.